school funding formula has been a point of contention since it was developed in 2008, even going before the state's Supreme Court. Many governors have been accused of not fully funding schools according to the formula. And that allegation continues today in a report released this week by New Jersey Policy Perspective. I'm joined right now by NJPP's Bruce Baker to talk about that report and what it means for our students. Welcome to the program, Bruce.
Well, thank you for having me. It's good to be here, talk school funding a little bit.
Yeah, so this report says that school funding has not increased according to the increases in expectation for our schools. Just break that down a bit and explain the disparity.
Okay, so one of the big issues is that we adopted this new, in New Jersey, we adopted this new school funding formula structure. It was adopted in 2008 and it began implementation in 2009. And that formula was actually calibrated or built on some analyses of what it would cost to achieve the outcomes the state wanted to achieve, actually in the kind of early to mid 2000s, 2003, 4, 5. But not only have we not fully funded that formula due to a variety of reasons in the decade and a few years since, we've also not revisited and recalibrated that formula to address the costs of what we expect of schools in New Jersey here and now, which have increased. We've changed the tests. We've set higher targets. We expect more of schools in terms of the breadth of what they need to achieve and in terms of the level that we expect kids to achieve. But we haven't recalibrated the funding to meet those goals.
And some of that funding would be for more qualified teachers, right, to help students get to those points as one small matter.
Right. The approach is about figuring out, well, what do different kids in different settings need to get to these outcome targets that we're setting, be it, you know, test score outcomes, graduation requirements, or so on, and to figure out those different costs. But right, the money that is generated by any formula based on those costs goes into doing things like hiring more qualified and more teachers to provide smaller classes with more qualified teachers, all the basic stuff that we need in schools to get the job done.
And so the funding formula does provide for disparities that exist between urban and suburban communities, right? And there's a mathematical equation to figure out if there are English language learners in a district versus a district that has more affluent community that's more able to raise a tax base for its schools. Just explain that a bit.
Right. So these school funding formulas, which of course seem like just painfully complicated, more so than they seem like they should be, really strive to achieve, they have two different parts. One part is kind of figuring out, well, what's the overall target amount of money that's needed in one district versus another to achieve the given set of outcome goals? And how did those costs per pupil vary from Newark to Irvington to Milburn to other districts around the state? And those cost targets will vary based on those differences that you just raised, that there are higher concentrations of children in poverty in some districts, higher concentrations of English language learners. Those are big factors in determining those cost targets. The second piece of the puzzle is figuring out and how much of that money should be contributed by the local community versus how much should be then provided by the state to kind of level it up the rest of the way. Often there's a bit of a relationship between those two in that a lot of the communities with the higher costs and needs are also communities that have lower capacity to raise their own revenues to hit those targets. But that's not a perfect relationship, which is why we have to deal with those two parts separately.
What is the solution offered here? And is it legislative? Is it coming from the Murphy administration?
Well, it's interesting. I mean, you pointed out like a minute ago that like SFRA has a lot of the right parts. It has these kind of levers in it that let us adjust the amount of money for concentrations of children in poverty, English language learners, and so on. And it has a ratio built into it to determine the state and local share. So the legislation, the structure of the formula itself, kind of, it has the right parts to get the job done. It just, and it was designed around getting the job done that was, you know, the job of schools as described 15, 17 years ago. So it really, the legislation, the legislated structure could remain the same, but it needs to be recalibrated, set to achieve these higher goals and set to, you know, better address the needs of children in poverty, children who are English language learners. A lot of that can actually be done through kind of regulatory adjustment to the statute without changing the statute itself. Of course, the first step is to fully fund the statute that we have. Even while trying to figure out how to recalibrate it, we ought to at least get back to the full funding of the intended formula as it was adopted all those years ago.
I'm sure you heard recently, six Jersey Shore districts have brought suit against the Murphy administration, saying that there is not transparency in terms of where the money is going and in terms of who kind of the winners and losers are through this funding formula. From what you've seen, has there been enough transparency from the Murphy administration?
Well, I think the transparency gets trickier. Again, it's one of those answers. It's complicated, sadly, an academic response. It gets trickier in these times when we get kind of thrown a loop like COVID, and all of a sudden we're not just fully funding the formula and producing annual runs of the detailed data of who got what and why and based on what calculations. That type of information really does need to be put out there annually. We need to understand, you know, who is underfunded with respect to the formula, and who, for that matter, is overfunded with respect to the formula in clear, plain runs of data. That's been harder when times get a little chaotic and when the state budgeting doesn't come through as planned. I think we've been kind of back and forth on that over the years.
I'm going to ask you for a really quick answer to this, not a quick question. I believe it doesn't warrant a quick answer, but is there funding available to increase, as you say, to meet the new requirements, to meet the standards? Does the state have the money?
Well, I think the state just needs to look carefully at the balance of the tax policy side as well and figure out how can we raise the revenue to support this formula, and also realize that the proportion of our economic capacity we spend on schools in New Jersey now, the percent of gross state product or aggregate personal income, is actually lower than it's been in the past. We've spent a larger share of our economy in the past. It's not unreasonable to assume that we could move back toward that in the future.
Bruce Baker, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.